So the question is, the reason why Mexico receives water in the Colorado is because Mexico delivers water to the United States in the Rio Bravo. And the answer is false. It is not that during the negotiations, Mexico, the United States were saying like, okay, if I receive this much water from the Rio Bravo, the Rio Grande, I will deliver this much water on the Colorado, or vice versa. If I deliver this much water, I expect, on the Colorado, I expect this much water on the Bravo. That is not true. What it helped out is that the conditions of the upper riparian and lower riparian for each of the countries. For instance, in the Rio Grande, Mexico, it behaves as the upper riparian and the United States as the lower riparian, meaning that Mexico produces most of the water and the United States as the lower riparian depend on the water from Mexico. Vice versa, in the Colorado, the United States is the upper riparian and Mexico acts as the lower riparian and depends on the water that is shared from the United States. This was very important. This singularity of conditions made the discussions very fair. For instance, when the United States and some of the states on the Colorado mentioned the Harmon Doctrine, which is the total sovereignty of a nation to use the natural resources for the benefit of some people without taking care of the lower riparian neighbor. That argument that was used in the Colorado by the United States, it was replicated by Mexico on the Rio Bravo, saying like, well, you know, total sovereignty, we can use all the water that we want in our territory, and we really don't care if we are affecting the lower riparian. Vice versa, if Mexico was claiming these Vallarta or Gamboa doctrines, when they were actually mentioning, well, you know, among riparians, water has to be shared and resources have to be also shared proportionally or in 50-50% among the two riparians. So that argument that was used, for instance, of Mexico and the Colorado, that same argument can be used on the Rio Grande by United States users. So what did happen is that these conditions of being the upper riparian and lower riparian that were exchanged in these two basins, that allowed for a fair distribution of water. Each basin was analyzed individually. It's not that they were mixed. And they were analyzed to share water in the most equitable way that it was possible at the time. And I think that actually worked. So, to be clear, there was never a consideration of exchanging water. It was just that these two particular conditions of being upper riparian and lower riparian inverted in both basins allowed for a fair discussion and a fair distribution of water, allocation of water among countries.